a PLC without Modbus communication. That is why we will reproduce the Outseal PLC Modbus functions in the Arduino Nano PLC and integrate it into VT SCADA. The Modbus communication protocol allows PLCs to exchange data with each other and SCADA systems. The most used of this protocol is the Modbus serial, or RTU, implemented in Outseal PLCs. When the Arduino Nano PLC is programmed with Outseal Studio, it becomes a Modbus RTU server or slave. Its digital outputs, discrete inputs, input and holding registers are mapped to the Modbus register addresses as shown. We will use the same circuit connection from the last video, with two push-button switches at the inputs and an indicator lamp at the outputs. Do the same for the Arduino Nano board. We should also pull up the up counter program from the last video and change the counter preset to I.1. Copy the counter ACC value to I.2. The Modbus discrete input addresses for switches S1 and S2 are 10001 and 10002. The Modbus digital output address for coil R.1 is 1. The holding register addresses for integers I.1 and I.2 are 40001 and 40002. Ensure a baud rate of 115200 and a Modbus slave address of 1 before uploading into the Arduino Nano PLC. Since I intend to use the Arduino Nano USB cable for the Modbus communication, I will keep it connected to my computer. Download and install the VT SCADA lights that support up to 5 Modbus tags. Create a new application and open the tag browser. Create a new port for the Modbus serial at COM3 in my case. In the Settings tab, set the COM3 port number and a baud rate of 115200. Create a new child under COM3. Select drivers and Modbus compatible device. Name the driver Arduino PLC. Maintain the serial RTU option and ensure that the station address is the same as the Modbus slave address. Right-click on the Arduino PLC driver and select New Child to create a digital output tag for R.1 with the Modbus read address of 1. Create digital tags for S.1 and S.2 with the read addresses of 10001 and 10002. Create analog tags for I.1 with a read and write address of 40001 and for I.2 with a read address of 40002. Notice that the values of the tags can be monitored on the right side of the tag browser. Right-click on I.1, type 5, and hit the return key on your keyboard. Observe that the value is sent to the PLC as shown. Switch S.1 status of the PLC is reflected on the tag browser when pressed. The counter ACC value increases in I.2. Now for the Arduino IDE programming. First, install the Modbus RTU slave library from here. Using the same up counter program from the last video, includes the library at the top of the program. Declare I1 as an unsigned 16-bit variable. Declare a coil array of size 2 as Boolean and for discrete inputs. Unsign 16-bit for holding and input registers if required. Create a Modbus RTU slave object with the hardware serial port. In the setup function, call the functions to configure and store the Modbus data to the coils array discrete inputs, holding, and input registers. Also call the begin function to set the Modbus slave address and the baud rate. In the counter class object, set C1.cv to I1. Assign S1 and S2 to the discrete inputs array, and R1 to the first element of the coils array. Also assign C1.pv and C1.cv to the holding registers array. The input registers array elements could also come in here like so, but it is not required in this program. The Modbus pull function is called to check for the availability of Modbus requests. Finally, the value of the first element of the holding registers array is assigned to I1, and the sketch is uploaded into the Arduino Nano PLC. For this demonstration, the Arduino Nano PLC is connected to the computer with a USB to RS-485 converter. The Modbus communication dip switch on the Arduino Nano PLC should then be turned on. An RS-485 to TTL converter module is required to make this connection directly with an Arduino Nano. In the VT SCADA tag browser, right-click on tag arrow.1 to draw an indicator on the IDE Studio. Draw a string widget for I.1. And LCD7 segment for I.2. Close the tag browser, delete all other items from the IDE Studio, and rearrange the widgets. Double-click on the string entry widget and enter counter preset as the title. Then exit the IDE Studio and click on Overview. Enter a figure for the counter preset. When switch S1 is pressed, the counter value is increased until the preset value to turn on the indicator lamp. Thanks for watching. The next video is on the Modbus master or client. Please subscribe to this channel if you enjoyed this video. Also like the video and check out previous videos from this channel. See you again soon.